Jeremy and I have been performing together for now 6-7 years, something like that. And all three of these pieces we've been doing a lot over the years, and it's kind of in the back of our minds thinking that someday we'd put them all together on a recording.
We met at the Spoleto Festival in Charleston, right?
Yeah, Jeremy and I have kind of led somewhat parallel lives in a lot of ways before we met, because we both went to Indiana University. We went for years to the Spoleto Festival, but at different times. And we got together for one piece at a gala concert and clicked, and then 7 years later we were still playing together every year. Large recital tours, and now finally making a full recording of these French pieces.
It's not a repertoire as important, because it's at least three pieces are amazing and wonderful pieces, and they represent their composers, you know, some of their most profound and inspired statements, and some of the most imaginative, I'd say. The Franck Sonata is obviously one of the great glories of the violin and piano repertoire, one of the great glories of all repertoire.
I feel very, very lucky that I got to study the Franck Sonata when I was 12 years old with Joseph mm-hmm. Gingold right. at Indiana University. He was my mentor, and he was a student of Isaïe, and Franck wrote the piece for Isaïe. So I still have in my ear Gingold's sound, and Gingold even imitating Isaïe playing this piece.
One of the things, the great French virtues of writing music is their love of sound for sound's sake, in a way. The beauties, the sensual beauties of certain sounds and certain chords. In the same way that French food is so attuned to certain luxuries of taste, you can taste these chords.
Well, color is a word that we musicians use a lot. When we use it with people that are not musicians, they kind of say, what do you mean color? What are you talking about? They think it's kind of funny that we use the word color, but yet we use it constantly in rehearsal, talking about color. And this music is full of color. The French music in particular is all about the shades of color and the nuance.
Actually, the beginning of the Ravel Sonata is a great example, because the piano plays alone, and it's sort of monochromatic, right? Just one color, one sound. And then suddenly when the violin comes in, you have the new timbre of the violin in the middle, and the piano suddenly changes, mm-hmm. Sort of dancing around all the registers, right?
Right.
And suddenly you feel like the colors explode
this,
in front
was,
of you.
This
yeah.
was no accident.
No accident. Ravel knew his colors.
He knew exactly mm-hmm. what he was doing. I mean, Ravel was so deft at using color and knowing the instrument so well. These pieces are very...
huggable.
Yeah, huggable, accessible. It's the beauty is there that I think anybody can recognize. I think certainly in 30 years we'll look back and be very happy that we have this testament to this period of time we played together. Probably next year we won't be so happy about it, because we want to change it. But usually after about 10 years you realize actually this was okay.
You know, one cliche is that when you're younger, you want to play faster. When you're older, you want to play slower. I'm not sure that's exactly true for me.
It should be the other way around. You should be more in a hurry when you're older.
Yes.